गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। स्विच ऑन द वीडियो प्लीज। स्विच ऑन द वीडियो। आई कैन सी सम अदर पीपल from 6B and all.
Sorry, ma'am.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
These bones, the bones, small bones present in the hands, they are known as carpels. Please note down that. C-A-R-P-A-L-S, carpels.
Ma'am, can you repeat it?
Yes. C-A-R-P-A-L-S, carpels. They are the small bones present on the hand. C-A-R-P-A-L-S. Okay? I just forgot to mention that the other day. C-A-R-P-A-L-S. In your textbook, it is given P-L-E-S, but I don't think that's the correct one. Okay. I referred with some other teachers also. They told it's carpels. C-A-R-P-A-L-S, carpels. Fine.
Ma'am, can you tell
C-A-R, car, right? Car. Then, pals, P-A-L-S, pals. Car. Fine.
Ma'am, can you tell the definition of carpel?
Yeah, it's not as a definition, just an explanation. It is the small bones present in the hand.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Finished. Who's asking? Ananya.
Ma'am, I had some network issue, ma'am. So can you say the spelling of the small bones present in the
hand? Yes, Devika, can you repeat?
C-A-R. P-A-L-S.
P-A-R-P-A.
Ma'am, can this disturbing sounds
are coming?
Yeah? Some disturbing sounds are coming.
Yes, some disturbing sounds are coming. I was about to say that. Somebody has to.
Malavika.
Fine. Now, shall we see a video?
Yes, ma'am.
The next question. Okay. We'll watch, the next question that we have to learn is gait of animals. We learned that?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Learn about the gait of animals, that is the movement of other animals. Do you think the muscles, skeletons, all the things are needed to move? All the things together and required for movement?
Yes.
No, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, for humans it's needed, but
yes.
for humans it is necessary,
but for other animals it is not necessary. So we'll see what all animals are there and what all types of skeletal systems they have. How do they move? With what parts of the body do they move? All that. Okay. Okay. So
okay, ma'am.
Video. This one is like a short film or like a cartoon, the video that we are going to watch. Okay, in that we have some animals that are going for a race. We have, for example, we have the earthworm, we have the cockroach, we have a bird, we have snakes, and so on. Understood?
Yes.
Everybody please mute. There is some other disturbance going on. Okay. So that's about the video. And just watch it carefully how each organism, how each animal tries to move, how they move, with what parts do they move, what all skeletal systems they have. Note all. Fine. Malavika, please switch off. Switch off the audio, please. Malavika. Okay. So watch the video.
Welcome to the annual Wild Olympics. I am Mr. Turtle, and I will be your host for the day. Before we begin, please join me in welcoming Miss Bunny, the two-time 100 meters Wild Olympic champion, who is here with me in the commentary box. Fellow citizens of the animal kingdom, please put your hands together for Miss Bunny. Thank you. I now request all of you to kindly be seated. We will begin the 100 meters race shortly.
Welcome to the lesson on gait of animals. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to describe the gait of animals.
The 100 meters race has started, and all the contestants are proceeding at a steady pace. The earthworm has already overtaken the snail.
Yes, indeed. It looks like the hard track is helping it to move fast.
You see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Earthworms can move with ease on a hard and slippery surface.
Notice how it is moving. It is drawing out the front part of the body, keeping the back fixed to the ground. And then it releases the back portion, keeping the front part fixed. Tal, did you know that earthworms have tiny stiff hair-like projections called bristles under their body?
Yes, note that earthworms have tiny hair-like projections or structures called bristles under their body. Earthworms have tiny hair-like structures, structures, structures under their body called bristles. Spelling is on the screen, bristles. You don't say bristles, it is bristles. Okay, so what are bristles? Tiny hair-like structures.
Under their body are called bristles.
Okay, fine.
These help them to grab the soil. See how earthy is first stretching out and then contracting the muscles to move? As a result, it covers only a small distance with every move. Another interesting fact is that an earthworm's body secretes a slimy substance that also helps it move.
Note that also, slimy substance.
By the way, is it true?
Ma'am, can you show that slimy substance once again?
I'll tell you the spelling. S-L-I-M-Y.
No, ma'am, can you tell the definition?
No need of definition, just write that slimy substance also helps to move. The earthworm's body produces a slimy substance. Okay, that is why it can move so easily. So bristles helps in movement, the slimy substance helps in the movement. The muscles in the body of the earthworm also helps in the movement. So do you think the bone is necessary for other animals? No.
No ma'am.
Because the poor earthworm has the muscles, it has slimy substance, it has bristles to help in the movement. Okay. Now, another interesting fact about the earthworm is given on the screen. Earthworms eat their way through the soil. That is, they eat up, then they go into the soil. They eat up, they go into the soil. Then they eat up, they come out of the soil. That's how they move. They eat up and then they move through that way. Understood? So what happens when some logs of wood fall in front of us? We'll just try to move them away, no? With our hands or legs.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
just
ma'am.
Like that, when soil comes in front of this earthworm, earthworm tries to eat them up and pave the way.
Make a hole. or makes place.
Okay, understood.
So that is so earthworms eat the soil when you right?
Yes, they eat into the soil. In their weight on their way through the soil, they eat up all the soil. And what happens is the earthworm excretes the undigested part.
Yes, sir. Soil.
And that is why earthworms are known as. Do you know what they are called? Something related to farming.
A bio or something.
Ma'am, like they
compost. They, it is a good compost.
Yeah, it is used for the compost, vermicompost. Yeah, they are known as the helpers of farmers. Why? Because they excreted material. The earth, I told you, this eats up through the soil and then it excretes the waste material. Okay, this waste material, when it is put into the soil or when it falls into the soil, it makes the soil very much enriched, high in nutrients for the plants. So when you grow the plants in such a soil where there is these excreted material of the earthworm, then plants grow fast and in very healthy manner. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is very helpful in farming. That is why it is called the farmer's helper or the helper of the farmers. See the rest of the video.
It's true. The intestine throws away undigested matter.
See.
As small pellets into the soil. This improves the quality of the soil for plants.
Very interesting. And let's get back to the action on the field now. Looks like the snail is way behind the others.
Well, that's probably because it has to carry the shell on its back.
The shell?
That's right. This shell also happens to be the snail's outer skeleton.
Like that? Shell. Haven't you seen a snail?
Yes, ma'am.
There anybody who hasn't seen a snail yet?
No, ma'am. No,
thank God. Otherwise, I would have to run to the garden and get a snail now. Okay, fine. So, the shell. So, most of the snails have a shell outside, no?
Yes, ma'am.
There's a shell outside. So, that is the outer skeleton of a snail. Basically, it doesn't have it doesn't help for the movement, but it helps in the protection of the snail.
Ma'am, can I ask something?
Yes, another question.
Ma'am, so the snails grow from the egg, right?
So,
yes, ma'am. So when they hatch itself, do they have the shells? Or how does they get the shell?
Oh, yeah. Ma'am, that's a very interesting question and I haven't thought about it yet. Yes.
Ma'am, I think that, like, I have read somewhere that when snails hatch, they do not have the shells. They then they produce a type of thing and make up the shell.
Yes, let's find out now itself. Yes, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm also curious to know. So let's find it out now itself. Wait. Okay, can you find and share the screen? I'll enable screen share.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, what I was telling is, meanwhile, let's discuss the topic. Yeah, the shell doesn't help in the movement, but it's basically for a protection of the snail. The other body part of the snail, what happens when somebody comes to attack it? What happens to the body part of the snail?
Ma'am, it goes inside its shell.
Yes, it goes inside the shell. Who got the answer?
Ma'am.
Hima.
Ma'am, it's Brisa.
Ma'am, I also got it.
Ma'am, I also got it.
As the snail grows, so does its calcium carbonate shell. The shell grows additively by the addition of new calcium carbonate, which is secreted by glands located in the snail's mantle. The new material is added to the edge of the shell aperture, the opening of the shell. Okay? So which means when it is born, It's not there, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Then it produces.
Yes, later on the mantle.
This carbonate.
Yeah, glands located in the snail's mantle that secretes. Calcium carbonate is additively added, and then grows into a shell. Yes, that's a new information for me also. Thank you for that question, Ananda Krishnan.
Right.
Okay, you can stop screen sharing. Fine. Okay.
So, how much was
that? Huh?
Ma'am, my name is Risa. I miss, like, it is my mother's mobile.
Okay, okay, Risa. Yeah, I didn't see the video also. That's why I called you. Yeah, now it's okay. Fine, Risa. Yes, so we'll see the rest of the video. So I was talking about the skeleton of the outer skeleton of the snail. That is known as the shell. It is made up of calcium carbonate. Note that also. It is made up of calcium carbonate.
Shell is not made of bones.
Yes. Then.
It is made of calcium carbonate.
Do you want the spelling?
Yes, ma'am.
C-A-L. C-I. U-M. Calcium. That's one word. Then the next word is carbonate. Write car first. Then write bone without an E, that is B-O-N, carbonate, past tense of eat, A-T-E. Okay, I'll repeat once more, C-A-L-C-I-U-M, calcium, then carbonate, C-A-R-B-O-N-A-T-E, calcium carbonate. Wrote? Finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the outer skeleton of a snail is made up of calcium carbonate. Savio, are you writing? Somebody is smiling there, not writing. Write down, take your book first. Everybody write. Okay, fine. Now, the rest. So the snail can hide itself inside this shell.
Liquid beneath the shell and can protrude out. The undersurface of the muscular foot is lubricated with mucus and the waves of muscular contractions along.
Okay, so.
Mom.
I don't know how to stop the record.
This is, there's one option like stop recording.
Don't stop the recording, just pause it.
Okay, fine. So I share the screen once more.
Yes, ma'am.
Nisi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
I'll see the rest. So they just tell them, and then last
thing. Your video is off.
Yes, the last thing that we were just. My video is off.
Yes, ma'am. Now it is on.
Ah, okay, fine. Now, audio, video, sub, everything is clear, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's see the video then. So, the last thing that we saw was the,
there's a shell.
Underneath.
No, ma'am, we only saw up to the shell, about the shell.
No, underneath we have the mucus. Yeah. We saw that, no?
No, ma'am.
Lead, mucus.
No,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, we saw.
Ma'am, the muscular part. Ma'am, it is the muscular.
It's not muscular. They see this one.
Yes, ma'am, we saw.
Muscular yes. Foot and it is.
Yes, ma'am, I think this
is. Oh, God, this has gone again. Just a minute. So, that the underneath part that has a muscular foot. The underneath part of the. Snail, okay, and that produces mucus. That is why it is very easy for the snail to move.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Haven't you seen after the snail moves, it leaves a trail, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Have they you seen that? Have you noticed?
Yes, like
substances. That is the muscular foot. There, that is because of the muscular foot, and it produces mucus. M-U-C-U-S. Write down okay. Mucus. So for the earthworm, it produces
can you repeat the spelling?
And it has, M-U-C-U-S.
Thank you, ma'am.
M-U-C-U-S.
Ma'am, can you say that the knee part is known as, what is the knee part known as?
Muscular part, muscular foot.
Muscular.
Ma'am. Ma'am, that's
your... Ananda Krishna is asking something. Please wait, Adha.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the nucleus, right? That helps the snail to stick to the surface, right? When it is climbing up right here.
Stick to the surface also, and also helps in the smooth movement.
Yes.
Okay, even if it goes above a blade or some sharp object,
yes,
it won't
ma'am.
Hurt itself.
Ma'am, it won't hurt.
Understood.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can you see the what it produces?
What, dear? I can't hear you.
Ma'am, can you see what it produces?
What is?
Mucus. Ma'am, she's mucus. Asking what it produces. Mucus.
It produces mucus. M-U-C-U-S. It is a slime-like substance. Mucus.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, dear.
Ma'am.
Yeah. So the earthworm produces slimy substance that helps it to move. And it also has the bristle, tiny foot hair-like structures, isn't it? So the snail has a muscular foot. It also produces mucus, which helps in the easy movement. Then let's see the rest.
It is made of calcium carbonate. The snail can hold its head and strong muscular foot beneath the shell and can protrude out. The undersurface of the muscular foot is lubricated with mucus, and the waves of muscular contractions along the surface help them move. The mucus also reduces the risk of injury from sharp objects. So, snails can walk over sharp objects like beads without getting hurt.
Here, Shelly needs to move faster if she wants to win. Come on! Back up!
Ma'am, can you tell why it doesn't get pained?
That is because it has a muscular foot and it produces mucus. That helps in the smooth movement. That's why.
I think he's trying to compete with Birdie.
Next is a cockroach.
And he's back to the ground again.
Little Roachie has all the talents.
It can walk, climb, and fly. Right down.
And also fly in the air.
He has three pairs of legs that help it walk. And two pairs of pairs of wings attached to the breast that help it fly.
Yes, the muscles of a cockroach near the legs help the legs for walking, and the breast muscles help the wings for flying.
Okay, so what happens for the cockroach? And note one point, it also has an exoskeleton or an outer skeleton. Okay, just like the snail, the shell of the snail is an exoskeleton, but for the cockroach also, it has an exoskeleton or an outer skeleton. Understood?
The legs of the cockroach also help it move on different terrains, like sand and wired mesh.
But see what he's trying to do now.
Oh, he's actually trying to climb the mound of grass.
Birdie seems to be leading the race, having overtaken
all. Okay. So what all things does the cockroach have which helps to move?
Man, the cockroach, it has its leg muscles that helps to climb, and the breast muscles.
Okay, so generally you can say it has muscles. Muscles helps in the movement. Okay. Then it has, what does
the
it have? What helps to fly?
Wings.
Wings help in the movement. Then what helps to walk?
Legs.
Three pairs of legs. Note down that three pairs of legs. And how many pairs of wings?
Two pairs of wings.
And there is, have you observed a cockroach? Have you seen a cockroach in real?
Yes, ma'am.
Many legs have small thorn-like structures, no? Spine-like structures.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that helps the cockroach to grab firmly onto some surface. That is, if it is sand or if it is a wire mesh, if it is a wall, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Helps to stay there. So that is about the cockroach. And next is a bird.
I expected that. Birdie has a body best suited for flying. Birds can fly by means of bony forelimbs that are modified into feathered wings. Their light and hollow bones only add to the advantage.
That's right. The breast bones hold the muscles of flight that help them to flutter their wings. And the tail helps to direct the flight. The absence of the urinary bladder also facilitates an easy flight.
They have strong shoulder bones, and they can walk and perch on trees with the help of their hind limbs.
But look! Sophie seems to be giving Buddy a strong competition.
Okay. So that's enough. Yes, what did you observe about the bird?
Ma'am, the bird has light and hollow bones.
Yes, light and hollow bones. That is one point. Note down that. Light and hollow bones. Okay, so humans have forelimbs and hind limbs. Do the birds have them?
Ma'am, can you repeat
light and hollow? That is double L O W. Okay. Now back to my question.
Ma'am, yes, I think.
Birds have forelimbs and hind limbs. Do you think birds have forelimbs and hind limbs?
Yes, ma'am. Leg part is hind limbs.
And the wings. Yes, there are bones inside the wings, no?
Yes, ma'am.
That are modified forelimbs.
Okay. Ma'am. Because this part, it is like normal.
Yes.
Limbs, and this is for the modified part.
Then the tail also helps in the direction, giving the direction and balance. Okay. Absence of urinary bladder also helps in becoming the light, hollow part of the body. Understood? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
About which all animals did we study today?
Ma'am, we studied about earthworm, snail, cockroach, and bird.
Okay. and we have snakes, fish, and all coming up. We'll deal with that in the next class. Okay.
Okay.
Give me the attendance. Ma'am. Anna.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. No. Abhinav Sarjan.
Present, ma'am.
Abhinav is present.
Ma'am, I'm present.
Okay. Then Abhyuday.
Present, ma'am.
Altina.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Ameya.
Present, ma'am.
Amita.
Present, ma'am.
Ananya Jinto.
Present, ma'am.
Ananda Krishnan.
Present, ma'am.
Ananya Vijesh.
Present, ma'am.
Antony Vijo.
Present, ma'am.
Then Arjun Krishna. Absent. Ashish Unni.
Present, ma'am.
Atul. Absent. Ayan Muhammad. Absent. Okay. Ayush. Absent. Can you help me with the absentees, please? Devaganga.
Present, ma'am. I mean, she's present.
Devika.
Present, ma'am.
Namastya. Emil.
Present, ma'am.
Francis. Geetika. Harriet.
Present, ma'am.
Haya. Absent.
Ma'am, Geetika is present.
Yes, Geetika present. Ismail.
Present, ma'am.
Kanishk.
Present, ma'am.
Nihal. Malavika.
Ma'am, Nihal is present.
Okay. Sanaika.
Present, ma'am.
Siyan Fatima.
Present, ma'am.
Ravana.
Present, ma'am.
Sri Rudra.
Absent.
Absent. Vinayak.
Present.
Present. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, CS present.